Almost everybody agrees with the saying that no one is perfect. But not everybody wants to live by the fact that no one is perfect. And that is why when they offend us, we try to justify ourselves and we don't forgive. When we don't forgive, it means that we are saying that everyone is not perfect, but we are perfect. But when we forgive other people, we are identifying with their humanity. We are identifying with the fact that they are not perfect, even so as we are not. But when we refuse to forgive them, we are playing the righteous, that we are more righteous than them. If I was in that position, I would not have done what they did. And so what they did hurt me so badly, I would not forgive them. If that is you, God is speaking to you this morning. Good morning. You are welcome to I Prevail with Joseph Adenuga. As usual, the King of Glory, the Father of Spirits, the God of all flesh, has put a word in my mouth this morning to speak to you, to encourage you, to motivate you, to inspire you, and to bless you. This morning, I pray in the name of Jesus as you listen to this word sent from God. God himself will enlighten you, give you wisdom and understanding. Take you to another realm in the name of Jesus. Take you to the realm where you will hear the voice of God directly in your ear and give you the power to understand what God is doing at this time. May you flow with God and not just flow against him. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Today I just want you to understand there are three people that are very exemplary in the Bible. Number one is Moses. Moses came back from the mountain and found out that the people had built a golden calf. They began to worship an image which they created. It was Aaron that created the image for them. And Moses was so angry, and God was so angry, and God said to Moses, look, I'm going to destroy these people in a moment of time, and I will raise you up as a nation. And Moses said to God, no, God, please don't do that. And God said, leave me alone, let me destroy them in a moment of time. And Moses pleaded with God and said, God, instead of doing that, why don't you remove my name from the book of life? I am willing and ready to go to hell for you to release and forgive these people. That is remarkable. Remember that Moses was not happy with their sin. Moses was wroth. He was angry. But in his anger, he remembered mercy. That was remarkable. That is more than human. You see? The second personality I want you to look at is a man called Stephen. Stephen was one of the seven deacons that was appointed in the first church. And he was full of the Spirit of God. He was full of grace and truth. He ministered with power. And so they laid hold on him and they stoned him to death. There's one thing I want you to know about stoning. When the stone hits your head, it pains. As you are trying to grapple with the pain on the head, another is landing on your stomach. Another is landing on your back. Another is landing on your eye. You are confused. Pain everywhere. Confusion everywhere. In the midst of that confusion, in the midst of that pain, Stephen still prayed this prayer. Oh Lord, don't lay this sin against them. Forgive them. Forgive them this sin. Wow. In the midst of pain, at the point of death, Stephen was still praying for those people that stoned him to death. Lord, forgive them. Wow. That is out of ordinary. That is more than human. That is divine. That is remarkable. But that is what exactly Stephen did. And you can do it if you are born again. Everyone that have the Spirit of God can do it. The third man that is remarkable is Paul. When Paul was writing the book of Romans, he was writing in an agony of heart that he said that I don't know what is wrong with my brethren, the Israelites. They have the oracle of God, but they missed it. But there's one word he said. He said, I wish myself were accursed for Israel, my kinsmen, so that, you see, what he's saying invariably is that I wish I could go to hell so that all the people of Israel can go to heaven. I am willing, I am ready to exchange so that let God just put me in hell so that all the people of Israel can go to heaven. Wow. That was remarkable. This is the same spirit in Moses, that same spirit in Stephen, the same spirit in Paul. Where did it come from? It came from the Spirit of God. And this is the reason why I know. When Jesus Christ, our Lord, was hanging on the tree, you know Jesus is the Son of God and is God himself. He said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. That tells me that these three people spoke by the Spirit of God when they were asking God to forgive people that made them pain. If Stephen asked God to forgive those who are stoning him to death, and Moses asked God to forgive the people that made him angry, what are you doing to those who offended you? Just little offense, you are out of balance. And this is why we open doors to some of these diseases. The reason why diseases like this one that is flying around is having so much power in our world is that we Christians, we have lost our power. We have lost our power to selfishness. And that is why coronavirus can grip us. That is why the church have lost its power. That is why the church is no longer as powerful as it used to be. I used to say, in 2,000 years ago, the shadow of Peter was healing the sick. But 2,000 years ago, the technological advancement was so low that there was no microphone, there was no loudspeaker, there was no motor car, there was no telephone, all these things we had. But in only 2 years, technology has advanced to a level that marvels. Anyone lived 2,000 years ago can come alive now, he will marvel. But spiritual development have not grown at that rate. If spiritual technology and improvement has gone at the same rate at which the technological improvement has gone, by now, every member of the church will be a miracle worker. By now, the whole world will have been turned to Jesus. But our selfishness will not allow it. You see, our lack of love would not allow spiritual technology to grow in us. Our lack of forgiveness, we don't have forgiving spirit. Our loss for power, our loss for money. You see, this has deprived us of the necessary power. You see, that is why we are not growing in power. And some who are doing some form of power, some of them are just faking it. Some of them are just using extra power and deceiving people. The reason why the power is no longer as at work in us in the church is because we don't forgive. We care only for us. It's a game of me, myself, and I. And in that kind of a game, the power of God cannot operate. This is where I'm going to stop. Think. You are able to hear this because of the partners of I Prevail with Joseph Adenuga. God bless our partners in Jesus' name. If you want to be a partner or you receive this and you love this message, you want me to send it directly to you on WhatsApp, just save my number. My number is +27 74 03 0281. Save it right now. Go to your WhatsApp. Just send me a simple message. Just say, add me. From tomorrow, you will receive this. Thank you so much. It's your brother, your friend, your pastor, Joseph Adenuga of the Prevailing Church of Christ, signing out and saying to you, be blessed and remain blessed.